guys, it's Dakota. So as requested, I'm gonna be doing a little bit of a makeup kind of tutorial video for how I do my makeup for ballroom competitions and performances. So stick around and I'll show you one of my favorite looks. Okay, so first things first, I pulled my hair back off my face. Then first thing that I'm going to do is actually my eyebrows. And then I'm going to work into my eyeshadow, and then I'm going to do the rest of my face. I find when I'm doing a lot of heavy makeup or a lot of black, it just makes sense to start with the eyes for me, because otherwise you have to go back in and clean up everything underneath. It's just a little bit simpler to do eyes first, then you can always wipe away whatever comes out or falls out, and then go into the face. So to start with my brows today, I'm going to use Ardell Medium Brown. It is like a pomade gel. I also like using the Anastasiya Beverly Hills. I just have hit the pan on that one. So I'm gonna go in with this one first. So I'm gonna use a quite small brush. So any kind of like eyeliner brush or flat brush will work. I'm gonna just use this little pointy one right here. So I'm gonna go into that. And with a blank spoolie brush, I'm going to push my brows upwards. So that gets pushed up. And then my brush with the product on it, I'm gonna line underneath. Then with the same spoolie brush, I'm gonna just brush everything down and do the top line. Brushing my eyebrows out so they're straight. And then I'm just going to go into the inside of the brow, where it's a little bit sparse, and just fill that in a little bit. Once that's done, I'm gonna just repeat the other side and I'll show you what I do next. So once your eyebrows are done, what you're going to do is go in with any kind of foundation, any kind of concealer, any kind of eyelid primer, and just clean up the edges around the brows, as well as start laying down a base for your eyeshadow to stick on top of. So I'm going to use DermaColor by Kryolan, and I'm using the color D6W. On camera, but in person I definitely see a big difference. Then I'm just blending that down. Eyeshadow, I'm going to start from underneath the brow with the white. I will not apply it to the whole lid, just up underneath the brow. So you can use any kind of flat brush for this, or a small fluffy brush. Nothing like too big where it's going to start spreading it everywhere. This is the BH120 color palette, and I'm going to go into that top whitest white shade, and I'm putting it right there. Just patting it on. Thank you. once you're done with that really strong white line, you're going to actually go into a shimmer shade. So this is optional, you don't have to do this, but for me, I like anything that's super like glowy, super bright. So I'm gonna go and top a highlighter color, any white shimmering highlighter on top of that. Next, you're gonna go into a crease color. I like to use anything warm, kind of like a rose tone or an orangey tone to do this. So again, I'm gonna go into my 120 color palette. And I'm just looking for any of the warm shades that I think are gonna work. I'm gonna go in with this one on the bottom. It's like a little nude warm tone.
Blend that in little circular motions into a crease.
Okay, cool. And now here is where the fun part starts. So I'm gonna do more of a black, dark, smoky eye for today.
So let's get in with some eyeliner.
So we're gonna go with the Anastasiya Beverly Hills gel eyeliner. I'm gonna start applying that really close to the lash line, but then you're gonna see we're gonna kind of like blend and smudge that out. Yes, I'll come back to you. You could literally do a whole eyeshadow look with just this brush, which is fantastic. But we're gonna go in with just that flat side into the gel liner again. And I'm gonna start adding that on the lid. You wanna keep it quite low. You don't wanna open your eye and then have it like stick to the upper part of your eyelid. Keep it quite low because it's gonna move up anyway. It is a gel liner. You're gonna blend it out. I'm just pressing it on. Now once you have the tops of the eyes done, more or less done, it doesn't have to be like perfect straight lines here or anything, because we're going to blend it out. We're going to set this with a black, so I'm going to go up to this dark, dark, dark shade in the corner. Notice I'm kind of using all the corner shades in this palette. And I'm going to start just setting that gel liner. Now once you pat it all over everywhere on top, you can start to kind of work it a little bit, tiny, tiny bit, into the crease and into the inner quarter. So now what I'm going to do is add in another crease color over that beige that's going to kind of blend in between that black and that neutral shade. Okay, so now I'm going to lift up the first layer of that BH palette, and underneath we have a whole other half of palette. So I'm going to use a bright hot pink using that same brush that had the nude color on it. I'm going to go for this one right here.
Yeah.
that done, you're gonna kind of clean up your liner. So you can either use a pencil, or you can use the gel liner again, or you can use a felt tip liner, which is what I'm going to use, to just clean up the edges a little bit. And then we're gonna also do the underneath liner, and then start to do the rest of it. This is in Harvard Black, and it's just like a liquid, any kind of liquid felt tip liner is going to work. So we are not gonna use her.
Trash.
So we're gonna just use the gel again. Whatever. Who cares? Alright. Cool. Now we're gonna go underneath with the liner. We haven't done anything else on the face yet. We just have that little bit of set E6W Kryolan foundation underneath the eye still. It doesn't really matter because we're gonna go over it later. Whatever falls out, it's okay. And then you're gonna go in with any kind of eyeliner pencil. It can literally be any brand, it doesn't matter, it can be L'Oreal, it can be Maybelline, it doesn't matter. Just any black eyeliner pencil or like the push-up one that you're gonna put into the waterline. Once that's done, we're gonna blend this out a little bit as well as set it. So first, you can use any flat brush. This is like a little concealer brush. I'm gonna just tap it into some matte black.
And see, this is why you don't do your foundation if you get any black. We're just gonna leave it.
So you're gonna just take your matte black, tap it onto the liner. Color, whether it's pink or blue or green, whatever it is, you can blend in underneath or any secondary bright colors, going a little bit close to the black on top of it, softening it, and going underneath it just a tiny bit. It's amazing. You can use this anywhere. You can use it as a highlighter. I believe it is called Twinkle Pop Eye Stick, and it is this like little like creamy shadow stick. It's incredible. I'm gonna put this in the inner corner of my eyes and then just blend it in a little bit. It really adds a lot. Even if you're just doing like everyday makeup, this is something that I really feel like anyone can use just to kind of brighten up your eyes in the inside or outer corner of your eye. So I'm just popping it right in. Cool. So this is where I'm going to start doing foundation on the rest of my face. Foundation brush, and I'm going to go again with Kryolan D6W DermaColor. shades lighter on the concealer underneath the eyes. Bobbi Brown Dark Foundation Stick. This is in the shade Walnut, or shade number 8. I'm gonna go into where I want some more darker, more contoured parts. Starting to look human here. So, okay, so now we're gonna do some powder, a little bit. I'm not really a powder queen. I feel like, especially with Kryolan, it is like, it's a mask, it's on. You don't need to like powder the shit out of this. Just a little bit, just to kind of emphasize a little bit more the lines of the contour, just to deepen it and set that a little bit. I'm not gonna go powder my whole face. Some people like to do that, just not my style. So I am ready to put on some lashes and some lips, some hoop earrings.
And we call it a day, girl.
So for my lashes, I am using House of Lashes. These are mink lashes. I do like using mink lashes, but I wouldn't say that they're any better than just using like a regular wispy style lash. They are definitely nicer to keep. They stay well. So if you're planning to reuse your lashes, definitely I would say mink lashes perform a bit better when you're hand washing them. But if you just like to throw out your lashes, don't spend the extra money on mink lashes unless like you really want to. One thing that I wanted to add to my eyeshadow is this color by SpaceCase. It's called Instense Stargasm by SpaceCase. It's this shimmery grayish color, grayish pink. I'm gonna go with a flat brush. I'm just gonna pop a little bit of it into the center. Under the sun. Favorite hot pink colors. Otherwise, I really don't like pink. This is Candy Yum Yum Lip Pencil by MAC, and I'm going to use that to overline my lips. So I hope you guys have fun watching this video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and stick around for more videos.